Hi ladies, it's Roseanne, and I have another video for you. I'm going to show you how to make this pretty flower. And let me see, that's not going to work. Let's see, how about this way? Nope, that's not going to work. Maybe you can see it that way. And this little flower I made using this mesh. And I bought a couple of yards of mesh, and I always try to buy white of everything, white flowers, white material, because you can always use your glimmer mist and turn it into whatever color you want, and it kind of saves you money because you're not spending so much money buying all the different colors when it's really not necessary. What I do is cut about an 8-inch piece. And then I think this is like, I don't know, 2, maybe 3, 2.5 inches width. So 8 inches long, 2.5 inches width. And put this to the side here so that, excuse my arm. To the side so that you can see what's going on here. I use my trusty circle, and I forgot to tell you ladies, I always use about an inch circle or a 3/4 inch circle for the little flowers for all my bases. And what I do is just fold this in half. And really quick and easy, instead of having to pull out a needle and start sewing, is I just put my tacky glue. Again, I use my fabric tack, and I folded this in half now, so you have two layers, and just start at the end. And all I'm going to do is pleat this by hand. And if you're using that tacky glue, oops, make sure you catch it on the bottom. If you're using that tacky glue, make sure your folds there. It will hold really well. Just push down with your fingers. And see, so I'm just pleating it all the way around. And it might be a little short here. But that's okay. Just bring it together. No right or wrong way. And my glue just dried out. See, if you don't use too much glue, and use a little at a time, then you have time to work with it. There we go. Just scooch this down so that it kind of looks even. So there you go. You have your... See, my fingers are sticking, but it's okay because it rubs right off. So you have your little base, your flower base. And then at this point you can do whatever you want. I mean, you can use your trims and put a bunch there in the middle. You can use your bling. You can use your pearls. For this one, it's kind of looks like the Prima ones. I just used this mesh and I twisted it. And we're going to put a glob there in the center. Just going to twist it, make a ball. And all I've done is just keep putting glue, keep twisting. Oops. So I don't know if I'm on screen or not. Just keep putting glue. And this glue dries clear, so you don't need to worry about the glue showing. And just a little bit more glue. Okay, we got the last little bit here. Okay, and I've got a little bit sticking out there, but I'm not going to worry about it. Oops, I need more glue. That's why it's not sticking. All right, so we'll put that there. Hold it down just a bit so that it sticks. And so you end up with a little bit of glue on your fingers, but that's okay. And let me see what does this look like? That looks cute, but I really want my pearls. So give me just 2 seconds here while I see if I can find my pearls. I have so many embellishments here. And I can't find my pearls. What happened to my pearls? Oh boy. It's just the way things are when you go to make a video, huh? Is you get ready to make something and your items are not available to you. Haha, I found my pearls. Okay, now these are the teeny tiny pearls. I don't know, 1 millimeter, 0.5 millimeter. I know they're not the regular big pearls. And again, all I do is get that glue, wrap it around, make sure you get it all the way around, and then you just start laying down your pearls. And right when you get to the end, snip that off and you just merge those together so it looks like it was one strand. Okay. Now with this end, again, all I do is just get a little, and I mean a tiny, teeny smidget of glue, just so that it holds together. And then if you have a little raw edge there, you just clean it up. But there's your little flower. And at this point, you can do whatever you want with the centers. You can use some of these, and I bought these again. Carla, thank you. I love these roses, bunch of wire roses. You can use it for the center, like that. Or you can do a bling. Like that. Or you could do a button. And of course I don't have any buttons available. Here we go, buttons. a really cute button like that. So it's endless what you can do. And again, you can use your glimmer mist and whatever color you want to turn this into. I'm working with reds, so I've been doing a lot of reds. You can turn it into red. Isn't that gorgeous? And that'll do it. That's gonna do it for me, ladies. Thanks so much for stopping by. Bye.